Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. I am Riya Srivastav and our today's topic is eating disorders and its red flags. Now don't forget to subscribe my channel and press the bell icon to have those notifications turned on. Although the term eating is just the name, eating disorders are about more than food. They're complex mental health conditions that often require the intervention of medical and psychological experts to alter their course. Now coming to eating disorders, which are a range of psychological conditions that causes unhealthy eating habits to develop. They might start with obsession with food, body weight, or body shape. Somehow in severe cases, eating disorders can cause serious health consequences and may even result in death if left untreated. Eating disorders can affect people of any gender at any life stage. They're most often reported in adolescents and young women. In fact, up to 13% of youth may experience at least one eating disorder by the age of 20. But unfortunately, many people with eating disorders may not think they need treatment. If you're worried about a loved one, urge him or her to talk to a doctor or a mental health professional. Even if your loved one isn't ready to acknowledge having that issue, you can open the door by expressing concerns and a desire to listen to them. So the symptoms of different eating disorders vary greatly. However, most include a severe restriction of food, food binges, or purging behavior like vomiting or over-exercising. So if your thoughts and behavior surrounding the food, weight, body image are causing distress and impacting their daily life functioning, it's time to seek help. Now, red flags that may indicate an eating disorder, which will include are skipping meals or making excuses for not eating. Adopting an overly restrictive vegetarian diet. Next, withdrawing from normal social activities. Persistent worry or complaining about being fat and talk about how to lose weight. Frequent checking in the mirror for perceived flaws. Repeatedly eating large amount of sweets or high fat foods. Use of dietary supplements, laxatives or herbal products for weight loss. Excessive exercise, leaving during meals to use the toilet, eating much more food in a meal or a snack than is considered normal, expressing depression, disgust, shame, or guilt about eating habits, and having a eating in secret. So if you are worried that your child may have an eating disorder, contact his or her doctor to discuss your concerns. Now there are various types of eating disorders that I'll be covering up and explaining separately in my upcoming videos. So if you liked watching my video, please do hit the like button. And if you want me to take up any other topic, please feel free to comment down below. Thank you so much. We'll be right back.